This book contains the opinions and ideas of its author. It is intended to provide helpful information regarding the subjects addressed and does not constitute medical or health advice. The reader should consult a medical, health, or other competent professional before using any information, idea, suggestion, or product discussed in this book. A PDF of additional material accompanies this program. Simon & Schuster Audio presents 12 Weeks to a Sharper You, a guided program. Based on the number one New York Times best-selling book, Keep Sharp, by Sanjay Gupta and Kristen Loberg. Read by the author.
For my three girls, Sage, Sky, and Soleil. In order of age, so as to preempt any future disputes over the dedication order. I love you so much, and I watched you grow faster than this book. Always take the time to be completely present, because it is perhaps the best and most joyous way to keep your mind sharp and your life bright. You are still so young, yet you have given me a lifetime of memories I hope to never forget. For my Rebecca, who has never wavered in enthusiasm. If in the end, our lives are just a collection of memories, mine will be filled of images of your beautiful smile and your steadfast support. For anybody who has dreamed that their brain can be better, not just free of disease or trauma, but optimized in a way that allows you to best build and remember your life narrative and equips you to be resilient through life's challenges. For anyone who has always believed their brain wasn't a black box, impenetrable and untouchable, but could be nourished and grown into something greater than they imagined. Introduction. A call to put you and your brain first. Welcome, and congratulations in advance. You're only 12 weeks away from carrying around a better brain that has enormous potential to stay sharp for the rest of your life. No matter how old you are, the good news is it's never too late to make a positive difference in how well your brain functions as the years tick by and you age. It's an incredibly responsive organ to our habits, an organ that we can improve on with the right choices. Indeed, your brain can be nourished and grown into something greater than you've ever imagined. And that's something that should motivate you to establish the habits that will keep you sharp for life. There's nothing brainy about it. Anyone can build a better brain at any age. Whether you're 22 or 92, you've come to the right place. We used to think that we were born with a certain cache of neurons that would slowly deplete over our life. We were told substances like alcohol could accelerate that process, and there was no coming back. Keep in mind that most of these outdated notions were based on observations of the brain during a disease state. For a long time, we only saw the brain at the time of autopsy, after its occupier was dead. This is how Alois Alzheimer first found the telltale plaques of the disease named after him at the turn of the 20th century. And up until recently, it was still only through an autopsy that a family member could be told of the Alzheimer's diagnosis with certainty. As a neurosurgeon, I hardly ever look at healthy brains, but rather ones invaded by a tumor, filled with blood, or crushed by trauma. Point is, we have just begun to quantify the healthy brain. And that's critical, because to maintain and improve a healthy brain, we must understand it as best we can. Once we started to look at healthy brains, our fundamental understanding began to change. We saw the brain grow and regenerate, not to repair damage, but rather to get better, and better, and better. We now know the brain can reliably revamp itself and be continuously optimized throughout one's life. We know the brain has a rinse cycle and can even predict when that cycle is most likely to occur. Sleep. We can tell when you are most likely to be productive and creative and when you are starting to redline on the verge of burnout. We can confirm that what is good for the heart is often good for the brain, but not always. Most exciting, there is now substantial evidence that you can grow new brain cells at any age. Think about that. You can spawn new brain cells and form new connections, whether you're a teddy bear-toting toddler, trailblazing 20-something, or tennis-loving centenarian. It's not nearly as challenging as you might think, but it does require some conscientious effort and planning. Anything worthy of monumental change demands that, plus some patience and perseverance. But you can also have fun along the way and learn new things that will surprise you and entertain you. After all, we are talking about maintaining and improving the most enigmatic 3.5 pounds of flesh in the known universe. It is the world's most sophisticated self-propagating supercomputer with the parallel operating system known as consciousness. So, yes, we should take the necessary time to care for this critical system, keep it shiny and full of the right fuel for it to truly run on the bumpy road of life without consequence. As you dive into this new workbook, updated with the latest science, I want you to consider a fundamental question. What is a healthy brain? Sure, we can well define a healthy heart. Same goes for the liver, kidneys, even your spleen. But the brain? Many will say that a healthy brain is one devoid of cancer, trauma, stroke, or plaque that interrupts communication and destroys memory. However, that is defining health as simply the absence of disease. We must go further. We must be more ambitious. A healthy brain not only manages memory well, but it also connects patterns that would otherwise be missed. Those patterns are what facilitate and further bolster the brain's memory making and banking. A healthy brain is also one that is not easily crushed by the tough, stressful toll of daily life, but is instead strengthened by it. We often think of a fit brain as one that can remember details well, but it is worth reconsidering this definition. What is memory anyway? We often think of it as a precise journal of past life events that we flip through, like a Rolodex or filing cabinet. Or maybe you see the comparison to scrolling through photos stored in your online digital cloud. From an evolutionary perspective, memory has served to recall situations, people, and sources of food and water to help protect and sustain life. But we now appreciate memory for its most powerful purpose, to reinforce our own life's narrative, the story of us. And sometimes our memories aren't entirely accurate, but that's okay. Truth is, within a given day, we probably pay attention to only 60 to 70% of all that's in front of us. Because the rest of our daily experience doesn't necessarily fill or contribute to the way we see our life's narrative, we ignore it. That means a healthy brain is one that remembers the important things while at the same time forgets the trivial. And yes, forgetting is just as important as remembering and can even help us sharpen our brains and make room for new and more valuable information. Scientists only discovered our, quote, forgetting neurons in 2019 in a groundbreaking study that further revealed the importance of sleep, a time period when these specialized brain cells spring into action. It's a beautiful paradox. In order to remember, we have to forget to some extent. As the wonderful evolutionary biologist Robert Sapolsky told me, a healthy brain is also one that has a wide circle of, quote, you, a brain inclusive to new ideas and new people, a brain less dismissive and more welcoming. As an academic neurosurgeon and a reporter, I educate and explain. I'm a firm believer in explaining what and why. Once you understand the inner workings of the brain, the specific habits I recommend will make sense. If I simply tell you what you should do, you are less likely to adopt the habit. If you truly understand why the recommendation will help your brain, you now have a story to recall and follow. This book is that story. Since the first publication of Keep Sharp in 2021, I've been delighted to learn the impact it has had on people around the world. My colleague, Aaron Burnett, has taken up painting to successfully help build cognitive reserve, a concept I'll define shortly. An 87-year-old woman from Bangkok emailed me to share her joy over her newfound cognitive prowess, more thinking power, faster recall, and overall better mental energy. And a 40-something father with a tiring juggle between parenting young children and supporting aging parents who felt mentally recharged and energized by slightly shifting his food choices, ending his soda fix, and prioritizing sleep. So many of you shared your own stories after following the 12-week program in the book that it became the inspiration for this new interactive workbook. As promised in Keep Sharp, and again in this workbook, it is important that you know there are no gimmicks here, only true self-discovery rooted in the best available science. To that end, let me be clear that there's no formula here to end dementia or magically reverse someone who is in decline. Some of you may be coming to this book with cognitive challenges or even a condition like mild cognitive impairment, which often precedes a more serious diagnosis like dementia. Or perhaps you or someone in your family is suffering from a severe neurodegenerative disease that has progressed from a mild state. The strategies in this workbook are designed to give you the best chance of optimizing your brain health. And while this endeavor may slow the progression of a disease in some individuals, no one can offer a guaranteed remedy to any brain ailment. The complexity of brain conditions makes the protection of peak brain function all the more important at any age. Don't give up if you or a loved one has cognitive issues. The more you work on improving your brain, the more you stand to gain in prolonging your brain's health over your lifetime and managing any brain-related ailment if that's a reality. So while there are parts to brain health that are beyond anyone's control, there are things...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.